Poverty stand at me too close. I feel like niggas don't want me to move on. They said the young promise show me no love. Sometimes I feel like I need me a new home. Working on this shit for too long. Running safe feels like I'm running in circles. Look at my kids, bro, I'm too strong. But somehow they got me running in circles.
What's up, guys, and welcome back to another video, man. I missed you guys, man. First of all, I just want to start off by apologizing, man. Unfortunately, last week I did miss an upload, man. I'm not even going to sit here in front, man. I was super busy, you know what I'm saying? Just had my show. Just had, you know what I'm saying, all those days on set. Just had a lot of things going on. And my creativity just kind of hit its peak. And I just, you know what I'm saying, didn't know what to do. Didn't know what to record. Didn't know what to post. And so I kind of just skipped a week. To any of y'all who actually noticed and was upset, I'm sorry, but I appreciate y'all for noticing. To y'all who didn't even notice that I skipped, y'all are fake. Y'all should be subscribing and expecting a video every week. But nonetheless, I digress, man. Today we are going to be doing something a little bit different, man. I haven't done a music-related video in a while, so I decided to kind of bring it back for all, you know what I'm saying, my musicians. Shout out to all my musicians, my beat makers, my producers who are subscribed to me, man. Comment down below if you're one of them. But today we are doing a beat breakdown. Now, I recently got back into beat making. I started learning how to sample, and I cooked up something the other day, and I really want to show it to you guys because this is something that I'm really proud of. It's a cool ass beat, and I just kind of want to take you guys through how I got here. So without further ado, let's get into the beat. All right, so here we are now in FL Studios. This is the project, you know what I'm saying? It looks pretty small, you know what I'm saying? But there's a lot of components to it, you know what I'm saying? If y'all can see this, there are over 41, you know what I'm saying, different things going on here. So, not over 41, there are 41 things going on here. So there's a lot, but let's break the beat down. First of all, we had this sample here from this song called Nobody Knows. So I ran that sample, just kind of, you know what I'm saying, to introduce the song. After that, I chopped up the sample a little bit, and I took kind of the first bit and I mixed it with the last bit, so it sounds like this. So that's what I did with that, with the sample. After that, I found this drum break. I wish I could tell you guys where I got this from, but I do not exactly remember which pack I got this from. But anyways, this is what the pack sounds like. So that's what the drum sounds like. So then what I did is I changed it and I sped it up to match the tempo. And I kind of chopped it up in a way where, as you could see, like, I put my own beats in it. So I kind of like played around with the pattern that I had, and then I used those kicks and hats, and I made my own pattern out of it. So I did this. After that, what did I do here? Yeah. So I went ahead and I added like another hat. So this sound here, there we go. Then after that hat, we went to and added the cabasa, which is like kind of like a shaker. So sound like this. So all together we have this so far. We also got a hi-hat in there. At the end of the day, when it comes to like making beats, or like at least this one specifically, I really try to go for like adding like little details, little details, little details, little details, and then you kind of pile them up until you get something really cool. So, yeah, then you got the snare there. I tried to make the snare a little bit more interesting than your average, like just like one hit, you know what I'm saying? So with this, I kind of had like a little pattern where it's like, it kind of echoes, you know? Do, 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 you know what I'm saying? Let's make it a little bit different. Also added some chants. And then I had to add some kicks just to kind of match, because my initial drum break, right, it didn't have that many kicks. So I was like, actually it did have kicks, I lied to you. It did. But I found it too aggressive. So what I did is I EQ'd it and I took all the lows out. So now you can't hear the kick, and then I added my own kick. Yeah, that's what I did. So this is my drum pattern as of right now. And then I added a nice DJ scratch at the end to make a dope ass transition right here. I think that was basically it for this section. So then once that was done, I wanted to like switch up the vibe. So what I did is I reversed the sample. Oh, look at me, goofy guy. All right, here we go. Oh my God. For some reason, every time I work on this thing, it just messes up the pitch and everything. But anyways, so here we go, we reversed it, but then we added a different break this time. So then now, if you want to hear the way it transitions from section to section, it goes like this. Why is it? Hold on. Shouldn't do that. Yeah. I got some vocal samples down here, but I'm gonna get to that later. But there was a bunch of vocal samples playing during this part, and then it went. There's a lot going here, so we're gonna break that down in a second. But we had to get this drum break or drum fill. Over here. So fire. I think it's actually off pitch now too. Yeah. Gotta be a little deeper. So with this beat, I was going for like a very Kanye vibe. And I know Kanye really loves his percussion. So what I went is I went into my, I got a drum pack here. African drums, EMW, I don't know what EMWDSV3 stands for, but I have this pack with a bunch of African drums in it, and it's just a bunch of percussions, right? Whew! Like, oh man, like this is so crazy, right? And then I put it together with a bunch of yells. Oh wait, no, I think this is the snare first. Because actually, initially, the snares were in here. All these gaps you see here. Yeah, it had its own like little groove to it that I just didn't like. So then I decided to add my own snare to it actually, because yeah, that was the initial pattern right there. And I don't know why, it didn't fit right. So I just chopped it up a little bit. All these three samples, I chopped them up in order to make it fit better. And then we got this. And then once I added those, I was watching a producing tutorial a couple of days ago. I don't remember whose. which video it was, but some guy was saying, man, when you want to take your beat to the next level, you got to start adding different sounds, different things, and just make your beat more, you know what I'm saying, entertaining to listen to. So that's what I did, and I started looking for some random sound effects in my kits, and I found a couple, so I threw them in here as well. Right? Then I found this bass loop. I wish I had I knew where I found all these kits, guys. But honestly, as a producer, it really helps to just be downloading kits and to have a lot of stuff with you so that you have options. But you know, another bass loop that I found, I put it in here. Right? So all together, oh, I did find another one, another super weird sound. That one I just treated as like a transition. So all together with the sample now goes like this. I would treat this like a little interlude part where like the whoever's on the beat will just start rapping, going crazy, like, you know what I'm saying? And then right here, you know, we got a beat switch coming up. So I went and I found a sample online. I was looking for like someone saying like, I'm scared, like someone saying that they're afraid of something, and I was gonna cut that and sample it. I couldn't find anything amazing, but then I did find a video of like some chick, and I'm gonna throw the video in right here.
There's nothing to wear. Did you guys hear that? I'm scared. I don't know what was that, guys, and I didn't do that.
Y'all know I'm a comedian. Y'all know I like funny shit, you know what I'm saying? So I had to get this video of this girl, you know what I'm saying? The video of her farting, saying y'all, like, blaming it on, like, a ghost or whatever. If y'all seen that video, then y'all know what this is talking about. But I sampled that in my beat.
I'm
scared.
I'm scared.
I'm missing something here. It's this one.
I'm scared. I'm scared.
So here's a beat switch now. This is a drill loop that I found on Looperman. Looperman.com. Another sound effect I found in my packs. Another sound effect I found in my packs. This is, I made this drum, this bass loop by myself, and this bass pattern. So, here we go, let me show this to y'all. It's a very simple pattern, but I did this just for the intro, then the, so right here is when, like, the beat tag will come in. Now it's made another one. And then I dropped it super low. So for the actual duration of the beat, the bass is gonna be this low, but then just for the intro, I had it kind of higher just to, like, you know, make something a little different. So that's what I did for the bass here. And then the hats on this section, I got in another pack. Again, can't remember where I got it from, unfortunately. I'm a very, very, very bad producer in that aspect, but it is what it is. This is the pack that we're working with. Made my jaws so much easier. I'm like, bro, I got no business looking for hats anymore. So then
Hans made another one.
I just ended up doing like a very simple clap pattern. One advice that I learned from another producer is like, claps are very simple because you just expect them to always be on the same beat, right? You expect it to be clap, 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 clap. That's a very simple trap beat. But then when you take one of those out, it kind of throws the ear off a little bit, and it makes for a dope balance. And that's what I did. So I went clap, and then you're like, whoa, where's the clap? And then it comes back there, and then it goes there, and clap, and then whoa, hey, whoa, hey, clap, hey, whoa, hey, clap, you know what I'm saying? So that's kind of what I did here. And as for the kick pattern, I literally copied the same kick pattern that I had earlier in the beat. Same thing, no changes. But, you know, obviously since the BPM changed, we're now in 140. Earlier, our beat was in 180. But as soon as we changed to this part here, we went to 140. So same drum kick, I mean, some drum pattern, just a little bit slower. So all together as of right now, we got this. Then I went in there and I added some like bells or a path or lead. And then right here, the verse is kind of the same. Like, all I did in terms of like arranging is like, I was taking parts in, I was taking other parts, like bringing parts in, taking parts out in terms of like kicks and snares and hats. But then later on in the beat, I brought in a different pattern, which is this. It was, this is like a violin I got from Omnisphere, and I did this pattern here. As a matter of fact, this would kind of be sick if I took these root notes and did something here. What would that sound like? Oh, shit. Hey, yo. I don't know why my brain is farting right now. But I don't know, I just thought it needs some bass. Sorry, guys. So that is now the new pattern, but this is very loud. So let's bring the volume down. Alright, so that's the new pattern now. And then once that plays for a bit, I added another pattern, which is this. I don't know if this is also violins. I don't remember what it was. Oh no, it's bells. So, and like, that was just literally just to kind of, you know, since we've been listening to this for so long, we just wanted to add something to, you know, switch it up a little bit. So then we got this now. Bass is so loud. We're gonna cut it because it was so potent. Too strong. But so that ends up playing till the end, and that's basically it. Then it just like it loops again, brings back like a hook vibe, and then at the outro just kind of brings all of the sounds that we had together. So it brings back that little piece that we had in the intro. I mean the intro as well. And then it kind of ends like that. So I said that in the beginning I had some vocal loops that I wanted to get to. I just wanted to save it to the end because it didn't really have anything to do with the beat making itself. It was just something that I decided to throw in at the end. So now I'm going to show you guys what the beat sounds like with the vocal loops that I threw in. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one, man. Peace out. Cause of this and that, they can never face the facts. They just wanna see me fall. Now they mad I'm making cash. Oh, I had a silver spoon. Mama never raised no cash. It's a Royal Rumble to the finish, and I'm making that. Tired of my singing, boy, I got.
you, now I'm making raps, cutting tracks, shooting vids for the gram, now it's back. And we coming with new cadences, I'm heating at the scene, I'm making steamy like we're saying.